So keep on pulling, but making sure that it doesn't bulge up, because if it started bulging up, you would have a difficulty taking it. Just wet your fingers so that it's grabs, the fabric is grabbed by your fingers. And it's a gentle tug on the thread, because the last thing you want to do, and then as soon as you've got enough of the fabric turned over, what you want to do is to stop that thread breaking. You want to try and grab hold of the corner of this. Now generally these loops can be created quite thin. You can hear the snapping of the thread actually, because my tension on my machine wasn't very good. It's an idea to slightly loosen the tension when doing this, because this is on a bias, and obviously you're putting quite a bit of pressure on pulling this. The threads do end up snapping if the tension is tight and the seaming was compact. So you want to make the seaming as loose as possible. Occasionally you have to pull backwards just to keep the fabric from stopping the fabric from, you know, the excess gathering. So that is all the dori. Now I will need a few pieces of this, and then from this I'm going to be cutting. I'm going to be cutting 2-inch long lengths for the loops, or maybe 1.5 inches. Make sure that all the loops are even, and we're going to be using so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. We've got 10. Now these 10 loops, we're going to make them into put a slight bit of a twist in it, just to make it a little bit more give it a bit more stableness, twist it so that it's more looped. And then you want to close these off. I'm going to close all of them off before attaching it onto. So watch the next stage of how I go on to add these loops onto the trouser that I've designed and I'll be stitching it.